Hi, everybody. This is Google Meet for Students, a tutorial for students. If you're not a student and you're a teacher and you want to send this to your students, that's okay as well. Hi, students. My name is Mr. Campbell. I am a former teacher and middle school assistant principal. And although I'm not your teacher normally, I'm going to help you today get through into Google Classroom. So let's jump right in. What you'll want to do is, if you're unfamiliar with this or Google Classroom, is you'll want to go up to the little waffle up here. Click on Classroom, and I'm using my son's account. He's actually a student right now, and he's using Google Classroom, and you'll see all of his classes here. We've created a test class just for this tutorial for you. You may get an email from your teacher that has a link in the email if you're not using Google Classroom, or if you're using Canvas or something else, that link might be provided there as well. So let's go ahead and click into a class, and let's see what it looks like. So I'm going to click into this test class right here. And what you'll see is we have the stream here. Right here, we have a link. This is the Google Meet link. It's going to be meet.google.com/ either lookup or a bunch of different letters. Now, because you're a student, you can't enter the room without the teacher allowing you to come in. This is for your safety and the teacher's safety. So if you click on it and you don't get in right then, just wait a couple of minutes. That means your teacher either hasn't opened the link yet or the Google Meet, or is busy letting other students in. So let's click on it and see what happens. When I click on it, it's going to open a window like this. This is going to allow you as the student to change a few things before you enter the Google Meet. You can change your volume or your microphone. You can also change your camera. Maybe you're having a bad hair day, or maybe you just lost a tooth, or maybe you didn't put your makeup on this morning. Either way, you can turn the camera off or turn the camera on. And you'll notice over here, the little green lines, they're picking up my microphone. I can turn the microphone off and it turns red. I can turn it back on and it turns green. Now, you'll have some other options too to join using a phone for audio. So if you want to do that, you can click right here and it'll give you information about the meeting that will then call your cell phone and you can just listen on the phone instead of being on the computer. I'm going to click on join now. And what you'll see is that I am in the meeting. Now I've set this up because I'm the one that created the meeting, so I can jump in. Here is the meeting nickname code here, and you might see a little message here that says meeting nickname can only be used with whatever your school district or your charter school or your private school .org.com or whatever is right there. This makes it so it's safe for you so that nobody else is going to jump in. They have to have a specific email like this email that I'm using or the email that you have, and then I can jump in the meeting. Now, I've got a few extensions involved here that make this a lot better. One of them is the grid view extension, and I'll show a tutorial on another one over there. You'll notice up here, this tells me how many people are in the meeting. Well, it's just one right now, it's just me. If I want to chat while everybody else is here, I can click on the chat, and I can send messages down in the chat option that everybody could see. Now, obviously, you want to be appropriate, not send messages in the chat that are inappropriate. The other thing, just so you know, is that your teacher has some controls that you don't have. Your teacher can mute you if you're talking too loud or if something's going on in your house and the microphone's too loud, or she can unmute you, or he can unmute you if you have a boy teacher. Again, if I click on people, you'll see everybody here that's in the list. If I click on chat, I'll see all the chat. Now, we have a few more options down here. Maybe you want to turn closed caption on, and that's where the text becomes words. So I can click on turn on captions right here, and everything that's being said will be down here in the text, as you can see at the bottom. It'll also tell you who is speaking. If there were other people in this meeting, it would pull up their voices and their information here as well. Now, you might have the opportunity to present in your Google Meet, which means maybe your teacher wants you to show something to the class, or maybe there's a document that you created or a picture that you want to show everybody. The way that you would do that is you would go to present now, and you could then present whatever it is that you wanted to show in that meeting. Again, you still have the options here to change your volume or your camera. You also have additional options over here that just talk about the meeting. And then there's a couple more options over here. Again, your teacher might have more options than you do. I can change my layout to one of these other different ones here if I wanted to do that. I can also turn off the captions from here. And again, you'll see that the captions are turned off. And I can go full screen, which takes it all the way to the full screen. Again, I want to thank you for your time. Although I'm not your teacher, I am a teacher. Hopefully this tutorial helped you get onto Google Meet and navigate through the settings. I'd love it if you'd hit the subscribe button and share with your teacher how helpful this video was.